Toyota lift. Looks like this here. 1000 Taylor Lane. Toyota material handling. Suite 6. Suite 6.
I can.
I make it so I don't have to throw it as high.
Thank you.
straight. A little bit this way. Oh, you go all the way back.
Yeah, cool.
This way. Straight back. Straight back.
Yeah, you're about a foot into the board. You good there?
All right, boys and girls, got her tied down, ready to ride. We got lucky on that. So, guy was pretty nice to me about it. Initially, it didn't look like we were gonna get loaded. See, this is a step deck, right? So it drops from regular truck height down to the step and then down low. So it's only like 3 or 4 feet, more like 3 feet off the ground. And they don't have the biggest loading docks. They don't have the dock plate that comes down. I mean, yeah, that would work, but it's really steep. Even if I did put the trailer up high on the pneumatics, it still won't come up high enough in a high center. So that's why he lifted it and I backed underneath it. A little sketchy, but it worked. It was right about at the end of that machine's ability to lift too. You know, these forklifts, people don't realize, they're heavier than you think they are. I don't know how much that weighs, but probably 10, 12, maybe 15,000. It's heavy. It's like 7 cars. So, all right, with that, we're loaded. Let's fire up, get on out of here. Next stop we got to go to is Ohio. We'll pick that up tomorrow. That's down by West Carrollton. That's down by Dayton. That's where we're going. So with that, let me go ahead and fire up and get out.
I've never known why it does that. If I shut it off, leave it sit a little bit, and then restart it, and then pull away hard, letting it almost die as I pull away, I can get some good coal out of it. Only get one shot at it, though. Off that Jeep, or just the T-top parts right over the driver's cab. I know it's a pain in the neck, but I've been trying to get that whole top off and the doors off. It ain't like today.